Hey, how are you?
I'm doing great.
You too?
I'm doing great. A bit sick, but happy to be here.
Hope you feel better. You have good beers at the bar.
I don't drink that much. That was good.
You live in the Netherlands too, right? Or
Brussels.
Hard to pinpoint somebody you only see at tournaments.
What?
It's hard to pinpoint somebody it's only at tournaments. Oh yeah, the dice. Let's see if we remember.
Okay, Ray, the legacy tournament. Welcome to round two. You have 30 minutes to make it.
Overkill. I would like to start.
Good day, gentlemen.
That's it?
Yes.
Can you do a table?
I know.
All right.
No, they're gonna put back the proper.
Yes, yes. They will be back at, well, not at the old pro points, but a new system of collecting points. And so you will never become an MPL player on points.
Yeah.
But, you can go to the player tours with those points. So, yeah, that's better. Now, if you play a GP, there's more to play for than just getting into the money.
Yeah, because like I really feel the this last year, every tournament I play, it's not worth it to come if you don't get the first place.
Yeah.
Because there's no rewards for being consistent. Like, if you finish three-time finalist, but you don't win it, don't get anything except the pricing for the second place. So.
Yeah, that's true. And, I think they got a lot of feedback on that.
Yeah.
Because yeah, they only did this for 1 year now, but they changed it already.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good choice. Because if you're not peaking, but a consistent player,
yeah,
you can actually go to all those player tours.
Yeah. As it was before with Pro Points.
Yeah, sort of. Yeah. But Pro Points also gave you some more rewards, more. They were eligible for way more stuff, and that's not now the case, but it's just more of a ranking system. But there are like six ways to go to the player tour, and one of those is the different point system. And I think you can also actually compete for the, if you are the top players, so the amateur players at the Pro Point, yeah, you can compete for the MPL. It's not a fixed seat anymore. I think that the bottom four or something are going out of the MPL, and then you can go in.
the end of the season or the year,
yeah,
doing the switch
exactly
between the two leagues. It's usually like that.
So it's not out of reach program.
Do they automatically switch, or do they have to make
I think you're playing at a tournament.
Yeah,
I think based on the standings there, you can switch.
Because, for example, in American football in Belgium, between the first and the second division, at the last year,
yeah,
the first of the second division and the last of the first division are playing a match, and the one who win can go to the first division.
Yeah,
like, even usually
in sports.
Yeah, like, even the last team of the first division, if they win the match, they can stay in the first division. They don't have to automatically switch.
Yeah, I think that's the case here as well. I think they have their own tournament,
yeah,
where the NPL is, and then the best of the amateurs are, and switches will be made into tournaments. I'm not really sure. There was a list like this, but I read it, and I don't know everything. Especially because it's not applicable to me.
Yeah, that's true.
I had last year at like 13 seasonal points or something like that, or junior points. Hard to play. Only these tournaments actually. Yeah. This is my second this year already.
Yeah, that's all. So the Deutsche Conference.
Yeah, I always judge, so I never get to play. Those are great tournaments still for legacy.
Even for modern.
Oh yeah, but I'm not.
It didn't come yesterday. I had a bachelor party.
Ah. So you can. Oh yeah, that's in the afternoon, of course.
What does the watch are in the
front? Congratulations, nothing wrong. It's just tardy because it's all beautifully soft. And you'll get some extra time.
Thank you.
Was it long for you to come here?
It's an hour drive. I live at Tilburg, which is south of Netherlands. No, it's not far, but the road.
Yeah. It's like. It's the same, it's also more than an hour from Brussels.
Yeah, but if I. Like Brussels for me is 1.5 hour drive on Sunday morning. And that's more than twice as far away.
Yeah, that's true.
But here I have to take all the roads, so 50 km/h, 70.
Yeah.
And there's a bridge where only one at a time can cross on the way. It's amazing. All right, let's try this again. Okay. I'll get Scotland back.
Yes.
Later. Let's go to Ghent.
The second time I played the text. The first time was the last one.
Yeah, it's an awesome one. Where
was your game? Was it?
That's an awesome addition to the deck.
Yeah.
Makes it way more sturdy. Thank you. You don't have to just knife that.
Last time I played the dark death, I forgot the 10 counters. Then I realized it. Then I realized I played it with Blood Moon on the board, so it was okay.
You did it okay?
Yes. I was not aware of what was going on. Like, did I forget? Maybe not.
Blood Moon's also a dark dash. You have DK. 20. Your turn.
Let me play Blood Moon myself.
That's not good.
You sure?
Pretty sure.
Pretty sure too. There you go. Good luck.
Thanks. You too. Start again.
Yep.
Went well the first time, right?
Huh?
It went well the first time.
Okay, I keep it to the bottom.
Thank you.
Yeah, there's also I think there's also going on.
Grazie.